15 miles west of Chicago in algebra class, a 16-year-old girl starts to panic. Her lips chatter, her heart races, her adrenaline soars. 3 minutes to go on her algebra test, and she's got four multiple choice questions staring back at her. All four questions have one thing in common. Her answers don't match any of the multiple choice options. As the final bell rings, she slams her pencil down and has a moment of clarity. And she asks herself a 10-word question. When will I ever use algebra in the real world? Now, this question has lived rent-free in my head for years, so I set out on a journey to find the answer. I found my first clue to the answer in 2010. At a California education conference, I saw one of the vendors had 20 people hovering around his booth. Curiosity got the better of me, so I walked over to see more. I see a kid tinkering on a computer. After a minute, the kid walks over to his mom with a big grin on his face, and he says, "Mom, I know how to multiply matrices." The mom can't believe it. She says, "You're not even in college yet. How did you do that?" The kid walks over to the computer and generates a new practice problem. He solves the problem in 15 seconds. I asked the vendor about this. The vendor told me he laid out a step-by-step, color-coded algorithm for multiplying matrices. And he got the idea from Elon Musk. I walked over to the screen and studied the algorithm. After a few minutes, I found part of the answer to the question, when will I ever use algebra in the real world? But I still needed more evidence. I found my next piece of the puzzle 2 years later on a shocking phone call. I got a frantic call from a parent who needed a math tutor for her daughter. The mom told me a grim story. Her daughter scored A's in algebra for the first half of the school year. Mid-year, her family moved for mom's new job. Even though it was the same algebra class, the daughter's grades slipped to an eyelash away from failing. Imagine this. We have the same girl in the same class going from an A to a D. The reason? Her teacher. Even though the daughter got the correct answers on quizzes, the daughter used a different method to solve problems than her new teacher used. So the teacher punished her grades. The result? The mom told me the girl came home in tears after class. The situation spiraled to the point of the mom scheduling time with a psychiatrist. The mom asked me, "Why does the teacher care which method she uses to solve these algebra problems? When is she ever going to use this after school?" What a great question, I thought. And more importantly, what is the answer? During my first three tutoring sessions with the daughter, I found another clue to the question, when will I ever use algebra in the real world? But I needed more evidence. I thought about the mom's call for an hour after we hung up, and it hit me. As a tutor, I can help students solve algebra problems, but I can't find a good answer to the question, when will we ever use algebra in the real world? To get more answers, I set up a one-question survey for my students. What is your biggest challenge in algebra? After 3 months and 5,000 survey results that came in, I saw the same three issues. They didn't know how to start a problem. They knew part of the problem, but didn't have all the building blocks. They finished a problem, but made a silly mistake while calculating an answer. I compared this to how the best algebra students handled problems. And I asked myself, why didn't the best algebra students I've worked with have these same problems? As I analyzed the best students, I noticed a pattern in their success. And it all tied back to the clues I found over the last 2 years of research. My perspective and my life changed when my theory was validated with 3 interviews. The first interview I saw with Charlie Munger introduced a principle called inversion. The second interview came from the conference vendor I mentioned earlier. He told me a principle called iteration. The third interview was with Elon Musk on the Kevin Rose show. Elon talked about how he built cheaper rockets using something called first principles. All 3 of these interviews and 2 years of research made the light bulb go on in my head. The best algebra students use these 3 principles over and over again. Inversion, iteration, and first principles all have 1 thing in common, and they reveal the answer to the question, when will I ever use algebra in the real world? And the answer is mental models. Mental models are frameworks for decision-making and problem-solving. After all, isn't that what we're doing in algebra class and life? While there are hundreds of mental models, I'll cover 3 critical ones for algebra and life. Remember the girl who had a math anxiety attack? Her test questions had perfect work except for 1 small mistake. She missed a minus sign. And this could have been avoided using Charlie Munger's inversion mental model. Inversion says, instead of looking to find how to do something right, think about ways you do it wrong and eliminate them. Years ago, mathematician George Polya, known as the father of problem solving, designed a 4-step problem solving system to solve any problem. Step 4, which is called the look back, reveals the secret sauce for the best math students. In a 1989 study, math educator A.H. Schoenfeld found that 60% of his students who tried to solve math problems using an impulsive approach skipped step 4 of checking their work. As a result, they failed to see their errors in thinking while solving the problem. The inversion lesson from algebra class and life? Check your work. Remember the high school student who multiplied matrices quickly? The conference vendor told me his algorithm used something called the testing effect. In a 2017 research paper called Rethinking the Use of Tests, researchers showed that students who take practice tests often outperform students in non-testing learning conditions such as restudying, practice, and other filler activities. The conference vendor got inspired from Elon Musk's quote, "Progress in any given technology is simply the number of iterations times the progress between iterations. In algebra and life, iteration works like this. Take a new skill and try it. Figure out what you got wrong, go study it, and then try it again. After multiple attempts, you get better." The Rethinking the Use of Tests research paper revealed the memory and skills built from the practice tests contributed to higher scores on the live exams. Remember the girl who came home in tears from algebra class, going from an A to a D? We turned around her grades using Elon Musk's first principles mental model. Just like life, algebra is a cumulative subject. Each higher level principle requires principles from lower levels. In a Science Direct research paper called Mathematics Growth Trajectories in First Grade, 153 students were tested on their mathematical competencies, including precursor skills. We develop precursor skills like number sense and lower levels of math. These skills are required to succeed in the higher level math class. The study found that K through third grade students who scored the best in earlier grades went on to score the best in later grades. Like Elon Musk said, First principles use truths we can't simplify anymore. We must learn the basics before we can advance in algebra and in life. After analyzing 7.2 million students in algebra, I've seen the good, the bad, and the ugly. And the difference between the best and the rest comes down to the mental models used by the student. Mental models help us make better decisions and build our problem-solving muscles. After all, isn't that what we're doing in algebra class and life? Consider this. I'm a fan of roots. Not square roots, but roots of words. If you look at the etymology or root of the word algebra, it comes from an Arabic word, aljabr. Roughly translated, aljabr means reunion of broken parts. Picture a puzzle. When we solve a puzzle, what are we doing? We're arranging the broken pieces in the correct order. And that's what mental models help us do. They help us put the right pieces in the right order to solve the problems of life. And much of this starts in algebra class. Think about it. Isn't each algebra problem and problem in life an unsolved puzzle? If you ever wondered when you would ever use algebra in the real world, I urge you to build up your mental models. You see, if the brain is a toolbox, we are only as good as the tools in our toolbox. And the mental models we learn in algebra build our toolbox for life's challenges. Think of your mind as a house. If problem-solving skills are the foundation, then mental models act like concrete. So the next time you sit in algebra class, wondering when you'll ever use algebra in the real world, think about the problem-solving skills you're building. Mental models create more than just better algebra scores. They create a better life. They do this through understanding. Because the first step in solving any problem, whether in algebra or in life, is understanding the problem you need to solve. I'll leave you with this quote from mathematician William Thurston. Mathematics is not about numbers, equations, computations, or algorithms. It's about understanding.